don't blink, could be over very quickly. Oh, wow. You just take cover whenever Ngalani swings that big, big leg of his.
Ngalani is about as wide as I am tall. He looks massive, like a superhero, the Panther.
And he does a lot of cardio. I mean, you can see, I guess, but I saw him on the treadmill for a long, long time yesterday. This was the day before the fight.
You can see that Bezon does not want any part of the stand-up game with Ngalani, but this is a bad spot for him to be in. Bezon has side control, but he's doing the right thing. He's pushing away, creating a little bit of space.
The strength to lift this man up like that.
He basically bench-pressed him into half guard.
Oh, wow. And then got to his feet. That was a tremendous feat of strength. And a big right hand, Ngalani. And he's unloading now. And Machado's in big trouble. He has to go for the legs to try and get some respite, but it's not coming because Ngalani kept going with the right hand. A tremendous effort from Machado to bring him down.
Nice single leg trip there. Machado knew he got hurt.
Yuji Shimada making sure that Galani's elbow doesn't make contact with the back of the head. Very important. That's why he stopped the action for a while there.
Yeah, he did exactly the principles behind BJJ. He weathered the big strikes, got this fight back down to the ground where he negates a lot of that power, those strikes that Ngalani has. Let's see if Ngalani can do another one of those bench press escapes again as he tries to get out of there. He does not want to spend too much time on the ground with a black belt, the capability of Machado. He's kind of going the wrong way. Now he's going the right way. Now he's stripping away from the side, but he's got to create more space. But that, all those big muscles, they just suck up so much oxygen. You know, they eat so much energy up. But he believes that he's like, oh, I'm a bodybuilder. That's true. He's a championship level bodybuilder. But he doesn't believe. Now he's got an impossible arm triangle by Machado.
He's got tight around the throat, but he swivels around within it. Very nicely done.
Good job by Ngalani to avoid that arm triangle. Now he's giving up the back, though. He doesn't want it to go this way. Machado's got that underhook there on the arm. He's trying to release that hand. He's going to drop some bombs first.
Bench press his man from this position. This is trouble.
Now he gets flattened out. He uses those hips to kind of spread him out. Now comes some big strikes. Ngalani's got to move. He can't stand there. Yuji Shimada's not going to take it.
Got to be careful of the back of the head.
It's like that Mohawk stick. It's just that. Like, imagine if you have this Mohawk. You can't come anywhere near it.
If you make contact with the ear, it's a legal blow.
You have to intelligently defend yourself. You can't just stay there with your hand protect.
Just cover up. He's taking quite a lot of punishment. He doesn't seem overly bothered by it, but this is a heavyweight and a big heavyweight who's landing the blows.
He's got to move, Steve. He's got to move. He's got to create a scramble. He can't just sit there. He's in the mouth. Too bad. Here comes the rain.
Covering up well, though, Ngalani. Those have to go between the arms in order to land. A few in at the side there, just to bury it. Ngalani's in trouble here.
He's got to forget about protecting his face and start pushing off on those legs. He can't stay there and just cover it up.
Lift those hips and do something about it because he is a sitting duck at the moment with 90 seconds of this first round still to go. The punches come hammering down from the Brazilian.
Hey, but they're not making contact. He's completely defending and covering up all these shots.
He is covering up well.
A little bit of the hooks on the side are getting through and landing there. He's giving him, there it is,
the arm attempt, but that's a strong arm. I'm not sure he'll be able to pull that one all the way to full extension.
He's trying to get it out, but I don't think he's in trouble. I think the elbow's past the groin, so he's not, he's just cranking on the wrist there.
That's a big voice. Now the right hand goes to work immediately above us here and cage side.
How much energy are these two expending? You know, Machado thought he probably had to finish and he's letting everything go with those hammer fists.
Big blows.
Ngalani's doing the same thing.
25 seconds left, bitch. It's been an exhausting first 5 minutes for these two.
Back and forth. Bezon gets back on top. Machado gets a knee to the head.
And now.
I'm surprised. surprised it's gone this far. Oh, big takedown attempt.
It's going to go into a second round. And not many people thought that.
Is this going to be the fight 88? Or fun 88 fight of the night?
It could well be. That was a blistering first 5 minutes.
Look at this takedown attempt. Once he got the leg, he was able to suck that leg in, secure the takedown, and he just never let go. And he just used it very nicely, was able to get on top, use a lot of the ground and pound. Here's Ngalani's answer to that. He was letting go a lot of strikes, but again, Machado was able to suck that leg in, weather the storm, and get a dominant position. This is where most of the fight took place, but Ngalani wasn't hurt by any of these. There's a submission attempt, but you can see that his arm is in danger. Machado was in control of more of the fight, you know, but Ngalani was back and forth, very close first round.
I want to see the man who can successfully deliver an armbar to Alain Ngalani's right arm, because that would be a strong man.
Man, he's got to be exhausted. He can't even get up off his stool. I don't know if he has the juice to get up.
There's a little bit of confusion in Ngalani's corner there. Yuji Shimada asking if he can fight or not. It took a long time for Ngalani to get up off his stool.
He's exhausted.
He will be very tired. He's got a big, big body to pull around the ring.
He's exhausted, and this is much longer than 1 minute. They got to get this fight underway.
Yuji Shimada literally had to push his men out of the cage and ask several times if he wanted to continue. That's the problem with a body the size of his. Carrying it around full intensity for 15 minutes is very, very tough. Ngalani is feeling the heat.
I don't know if he's going to have the juice to stop this takedown. Here he is, clearly holding the cage to avoid the takedown.
He's gone. He's exhausted, Ngalani. It's over. You can see that Alain Ngalani didn't really want much of that fight once the second round started. And look at the emotion. This fight brought to you by Barocca. Every day is a big day. Start it right with Barocca. Don't blink.
Subora coming right at Ngalani. You can see him.
Oh, wow. I flinched down here.
You can just see him trying to set up that big left kick. He's like pulling it all the way back from Hong Kong. Ooh, that was a nice body shot right there.
His legs are so huge that he's getting really hit. In come the punches, and Sabora's in trouble. Those legs are just so strong and powerful.
You gotta be careful once you feel that your opponent weaken a little bit, and he's starting to exert a lot of energy right there. He's gotta be careful he doesn't gas himself out, but he's going right back to the body again.
Left up to the body. Oh, big punches to the face.
Oh,
untidy with the ground and pound. Can he get the space to work hard? The hammer blows come down. That's 4, 5. The left hand, Subora trying to block them, but he's having precious little success with it. Subora is grazed and possibly cut on the head. Olivier Costa is ready to pounce. It's finished.
Here you can see that vicious left body kick that hurt Subora.
You saw him grimace, yeah.
And you can see him just fading a little bit. And Ngalani jumps all over him with that big right hand, drops him right there. And then you can just see him dribbling the head off the canvas with big right hands.
Ready, choke!
I tried on the 3XL gloves he's got on, and it looked like I was wearing super serious gloves, Michael.
Subpoena in the red, Machado. Camouflage, gray, black and white. Sakino on the outside here. Look to shoot in and try and put the BJJ black belt on his back. Sakino's chin wide open though here. Fires out a back kick there. Here's the Japanese warrior. What a personality. Fan favorite is Sakino. The prettiest of technique to watch, but thoroughly entertaining. Machado gloves up high. He knows the power that Shrek packs in those hands. Probing with the lead hand here. Machado goes up to the head.
Machado might want to start going to the body with those kicks. He's wide open for a nice, beautiful takedown from Sakine.
And indeed does put the BJJ black belt on his back. Goes to side control, lands a knee. And he'll have this big fella on top of him.
Oh, this is Sakine's world. The 7-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu champion. He's got him on top. Oh, floats over the back. Secures, but look at Bimizol just standing right back up. But Sekine drags him back down to the ground. Sekine moves very well on the ground.
Strength of the jersey from the 117-kilo Hideki Sekine. Here in the first round, having the back of Machado. Machado walls towards the cage. Impressive start here from Sekine.
Sekine's got to make Machado carry his weight a little bit more. He's got to get a little bit higher on the back. Because that's way. With that body lock, Sekine is able to drag Machado wherever he wants.
Just ragdolling Machado early on here, Sekine, who began training in judo as a six-year-old after being the victim of bullying at school. Fell in love with the art, continued his training all the way through college at Yamanashi Gakuin University. And still ragdolling Machado here, Mitch.
See the frustration starting to build on Alessandro Machado. He's got to break that grip. When he stands back up, he immediately has to put both hands on one of Sekine's hands and start to push away, because Sekine has that grip and he's able to just toss him around.
Top position now for Hideki Kasinga. Can he get inside? He is inside the half guard. Can he posture up and work those massive meat hooks? Machado trying to work his way out of this predicament. Sekine has been a dominant force. Takes the back, standing again, does the Japanese warrior.
He's got to put his back up against the cage and he's got to start fighting that grip. He's got to put both hands on one of Sekine's arms and start to separate the body lock. Sekine might just take his right leg behind and trip him back down to the ground. Just like that.
BJJ black belt under Marcos and Roberto Satoshi Souza is Sekine. Looks for another wrenching takedown on Machado.
Oh, Machado was able to transition to a single leg. Can't hold on to the ring like that. The cage.
Sekine is on. Actually looking for his first win in one championship. He is 0-2 here so far. Impressive in the opening round. The big fella from Japan. Overhand left there. Misses the target from Machado. Double leg to a single leg now from Sekine. Gives up on that. Machado, where does he go from here, Dragon?
Machado, he's got to see how Sekine is controlling that left arm there. He's not able to swing the arm around, so he can't stand back up. Sekine's got such powerful paws. He's just holding on to the hands of Machado, and he's not able to get back up. Good job by Machado to work his way back up to his feet. Now he's got the wizard, and he's able to get the underhook on the left side. Now he's got to try to pry Sekine up. Sekine's got the body lock. He's been ragdolling Machado all night with that.
This is the fifth of sixth of our prelim card inside the magnificent Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. It's one championship conquest of champions. Hope you're enjoying it, folks. Live on Facebook, live on Twitter. Also, make sure you download the One Super app. It's all fights. It's all live. It's all absolutely free. 25 seconds to go in this one.
Good job.
Fantastic round for Sekine, Dragon.
Good job for Machado to try to frame away to create a little bit of space, but Sekine is relentless inside that clinch. But no, Machado's able to get away. He finally gets the giant off of him.
This one's going to go a lot longer than many pundits thought. It's going to get out of the first round and go into the second. Second round of three of this heavyweight stash between Alessandro Machado of Brazil and Hideki Sekine of Japan. The Mall of Asia Arena, I'd say we're now at about 85%, and they are still filing in. I'm telling you, Mitch, they are going to turn away thousands at the door tonight. This is the hottest ticket in town, the biggest one championship event. It's Conquest of Champions.
Distance with that rear leg push kick, and his own gets inside the pocket, starts letting the hands go a little bit.
Big looping punches there from Sekine. He's starting to gas the big fella, hands around the waist, but I'm not sure if Machado's striking can really capitalize on it. Shoots him for a single here. Sekine tries for a driving takedown to no avail on that occasion. Goes to a double leg now, does the big man. Looping right hook there from Sekine, and Shrek breaks off.
Good job by Machado to avoid that bum rush of a takedown. Utilize the underhooks, pick Sekine up, and push him off.
Machado just staying out of range of the hands of Sikinek. Overhand right there. Is this when that lactic acid starts to build up and slow you down and get inside the muscles, make you make the arms heavy, the legs heavy?
If it starts, if you do something you're unused, if you're not used to it, and striking, they pull through. Oh, nice right hand there, landed by Machado. It's definitely going to slow you down, but if this is what they're doing, if they're grappling, if they're clinching, oh, Machado, this is opening.
Sikinek on his back now. Here comes the ground and pound from Machado. Ready? Fight!
Subora against Vera is brought to you by Monster Energy.
Look for Vera to keep the distance. Land some leg kicks. After talking to him a little bit, he's going to stay on the outside. Throw some leg kicks to the takedowns there. He'll take it. There he goes. Look for Subora to step in big with some big punches, try and get the knockout. Oh! Blocked him already!
Top of the head, and it sent Subora back to the cage
big,
wall.
Big knees in the clinch.
Three knees to the head. The crowd going absolutely crazy here in Manila. Is this going to be a quick finish?
Grant is doing work right now. He needs to get back on that head kick again. Maybe set it up with a low and go back up top.
Subora is hurt. He's grimacing despite that flying punch that he just tried. Boom. Takes a big kick to the midriff. But he's still punching back. Vera still throwing those kicks there to the inside of the thigh.
Grant is just picking him apart right now. Subora needs to actually back away.
Subora grimaces again. He's suffering pain somewhere. Nice short right hand from the Ukrainian. Solid ramrod jab from Vera.
Vera's got to keep those hands up, though. Igor's still dangerous. It's first round. It's still fresh. Grant's pawn on the outside a little bit. But then we probably go to the body, the inside of the leg again. You can tell he's getting ready to throw that kick. Grant needs to keep those hands up tight, though. Igor's recovered now. He's feeling fresh.
So good, so good, Grant. So good. Nice job.
Both men swinging, both men just ducking under the punches. Heavyweights, it could finish any second. Big man can get that leg up really high. Oh, right hand and a left as well. From Subora.
Subora's bleeding a little bit from the tip, the bridge of his nose.
He was a little bit uncomfortable with something he's been practicing for a while now, and it could be the nose that's causing him trouble.
A little bit of redness around the left eye as well. Granny keeps switching stance, keeping Igor thrown off a little bit. More still dangerous, he's coming in with that big right. This is what he said he was going to do.
Oh, kick to the midriff. And that kick just above the knee that could hyperextend it. Damaging kick, that is. Straight pushes the thigh back, locks the knee up. Good left hand from Igor. Sent Brandon back a pace. Looks for it again. Leaps in with it. Nice high guard from Brandon Vera. Left hand again from the Ukrainian. Oh, right hand, it was a good one.
Brandon stepping in, throwing those short little choppy elbows. Stand on the outside, really executing his game plan to a T right now. I talked to him the other day, he said this was exactly what he wanted to do.
Brandon looking for the left hand downstairs. Gets clipped by a couple. Oh, left hand, and it's over now. Olivier Costa seen enough. Brandon Vera has come home, and he's picked up a first round victory.
Here we go. From Studio City in Macau, China, one Super Series match under kickboxing's global rule set. Look out for the spinning hook kicks of Alain Ngalani. Look out for those Dutch-style low kicks on Tariq Kebabi.
Not clinching, okay. Go!
You can see, Michael, he's doing exactly what you talked about. Galani's trying to create that space. Kebabez is trying to close it and get nice and tight.
What Galani's got to be careful of is not to drop his hands and leave them down around his waist, because Kebabez does have heavy artillery in the leather.
Go!
Let's see how quickly Galani can get used to the distance. Turning back into the liver of the Moroccan.
Galani's trying to kick, but Kebabez is trying to throw those hands.
Galani gets underneath Kebabez, throws a knee, completely legal under the kickboxing rule set. Kebabez comes forward again. Gut muncher, then went up to the jaw from Galani, throws the overhand right. Kebabez trying to get in close to negate the spinning kicks of Galani. Look how low Galani's hands are. The big man's got to keep the gloves up. Kebabez throws an uppercut. And Galani drifts off. Goes counterclockwise, staying out of the right hand and right kick range of Kebabez. Body shot from Galani. He's quick for a big man, is Alain Ngalani. An inside kick, ducks under the left hook, clinches up.
Not clinching, okay?
No clinching allowed in the kickboxing global rule set here at One Super Series.
It's like he's dropping his head to possibly go in for a takedown, and that's where he's ended up in that clinch that the referee's warned about.
How about that? The Andy Hook style X kick from Galani. Galani does have a background in Kyokushin Karate. The axe kick is a trademark of the Kyokushin Karateka. The likes of Andy Hook, Claube Feitosa, Francisco Filio, and we saw it there from Alain Ngalani. Mawashi Getty roundhouse kick off the lead leg from Galani. Good jab two from the Cameroonian. Got to get out of the corner. Here come the heavy hands from the Moroccan Kebabez. Throws the knee. Kebabez unloading. Doesn't want to let Galani out of the corner here.
Go.
Galani, jab two, kangaroo down the center corridor. Jab two again. Uppercut. Kebabez with the knee. Galani's got to get out of the corner now. Kebabez running the punches. Gives back a solid right hand. Galani's been caught. Galani's been caught. Here comes Kebabez. Goes to the liver. Goes to the head. It's all scoring stuff for Tariq Kebabez.
Kebabez is throwing some serious heat right in the corner. Galani's got to be careful when he's dropping his head, trying to create head movement. Kebabez is throwing that knee right up the middle.
Galani goes to the body. Kebabez has had the higher output with the hands. He tags him again. We go to the tag. Now, once again, we've got three judges ringside. They are scoring on a 10-point must system, which means give the winner of the round 10 points, the loser of the round 9 points. If you think Galani won it, you give him 10 points. You give Kebabez 9. If you think it was vice versa, Kebabez gets 10, Galani gets 9. In my opinion, Mitch, with the flurry that Kebabez had in the corner here against Galani, it's a 10-9 round for Tariq Kebabez.
Galani looked good for those first couple minutes of that round. He was moving quite well. He was landing the kicks. But Kebabez turned it on in those last 30 seconds to steal the round away, landing some huge thunderous shots.
Do you see anything here, Mitch? The fact that Kebabez is standing, Galani's taking a seat. He is 42 years old.
And he's stacked with muscle, like you said, the seafood platter, Michael. He is stacked, and all that muscle eats up a lot of oxygen. But we've said that about him in the past. And in his last match against Arumbold, he looked fantastic and went the distance.
The size of the chest there on Galani, it should have its own zip code. Here we go, second round of three. If there is a knockdown in the round and the other opponent does not achieve a knockdown of his own, it'll be a 10-8 round. Kebabez coming forward strongly with her hands again. Let's see if Galani starts to wind with the spinning hook kicks. Maybe goes to the liver, maybe goes to the jaw. Accidental groin strike there on Galani.
Kebabez immediately knew, threw up his hand as just a way to say, I'm sorry, apologetic. But it also gives, if there is a little bit of fatigue settling in for Galani, a little bit of time to catch a breather, relax a bit.
Let's take a look here and see if we can determine what exactly happened with this accidental groin strike. Barbers comes forward, throws, okay, it was an inside thigh kick designed to hit the inside right thigh of Ngalani. It missed the target and caught Ngalani square, in a place where you don't want to be caught. Apologies from Kababes. It was not deliberate, nothing malicious in it. And there will be recovery time here. As much as 3 minutes for Alain Ngalani. How do you see Ngalani going so far in his return to kickboxing, Mitch? A four-time world champion who has plied his trade of late in the global rule set in the cage.
We've seen him primarily in mixed martial arts events, and you can see that Kabanez is not scared to strike and stand with him. Most of these guys are timid to exchange like this with Ngalani, but Kababes is not scared at all, marching forward, throwing those heavy hands.
Touch-style Moroccans, they are not scared of anyone. You're talking about a pedigree that includes the likes of Bada Hari. These guys come forward, and they come forward hard and nasty, as Tarek Kababes is doing again here. We recommence in the second round. Axe kick from Ngalani. Once again, channeling his inner Kyokushin, the martial art, the hardest form of karate that he began his career in.
Trying to utilize that jab, create a little bit of space, but Kababes is trying to corner him. He's trying to cut the angles, so he's trapping Ngalani inside the corner, but Galani's moving around very well.
This is a very large ring here at One Super Series, and both of these big men are traversing a lot of ground. How about that? The elasticized legs of Ngalani. Another attempted axe hit. What you're trying to do with the axe hit is to bring the heel, the hardest bone in the body, down on the collarbone or on the nose or on the forehead of your opponent.
Ngalani's having a little more success as southpaw. He switched to a southpaw stance with his left hand back, and he's utilizing that right jab more successfully.
Kababes, who has had to travel the longer distance to get here, all the way from the Netherlands to be here tonight. Ngalani, it was only a 45 or 50 minute ferry ride from Hong Kong.
The referee has given Ngalani a warning to avoid the clinching. Go!
It's a little bit of a spillover there from Galani's MMA career. But he his natural instinct in recent years has been to move in close and clinch up with opponents. Good outside leg from Kababes, and Ngalani off the rope for that powerful right hand.
But I also think it's his head movement. You can see Ngalani circles out to the head, he moves his head out, and then at that point, Kababes closes the distance, and they end up in the clinch. But I don't think it's purposeful. I don't think he's trying to clinch. His hands are down. It's hard to clinch with your hands down.
Kababes looks for that bolo punch, goes for an outside leg kick, trying to tenderize the legs of the big Cameroonian. Uppercut again went higher than the ceiling. Referee breaks them.
See, it's just that head movement that he's ending up entangled.
Go, go!
Ngalani on the back foot, throws another axe hit, needs to be on the front foot a little more here, does Ngalani. Kababes, the outside leg kick, he has taken on and beaten some very good names, Tarek Kababes, over the years, including Roman Kriklia.
Ready? Go!
Of course, Alain Ngalani in his kickboxing days went into battle against the likes of Bob Sapp, against Carter Williams, against Michael McDonald. And here he is, two rounds deep with one remaining. He's returned to kickboxing, and there is the Kyokushin axe kick from Alain Ngalani. It is spectacular, though ineffective so far.
I'm going to put you on the spot, Michael. You gave the first round to Kababes. How did you see the second round?
I think a much closer round, a difficult round for the judges to score. If I was going to edge it, though, Mitch, I've got to go Tarek Kababes again. A very slight 10-9 round. I feel Ngalani is backing up a little too much for my liking. Doesn't look good to the judges scoring here ringside. And Kababes is landing four hands. While we have seen Ngalani do the spectacular stuff, it hasn't landed for him yet. It hasn't had an effect on Tarek Kababes. He's going to start to take his toll on Kababes with one round remaining. 3 minutes only, Mitch.
And the spectacular techniques do score slightly higher.
So let me explain. 10-point must system. I gave the first round 10-9 Kababes. I gave the second round 10-9 Kababes. My scorecard goes 20-18 Kababes, which means to even the score, Ngalani needs a 10-8 round, needs a knockdown round on Tarek Kababes.
Now, fans at home, Michael Chiavello is not a judge. He's just pretending to be one on TV.
Outside leg kick from Ngalani. Good jab to overhand right there from the Cameroonian. Kebabes looks at the power in the right. High left roundhouse kick from Ngalani. Double forearm guard blocks the kick. Oh, counter from Kebabes. Ngalani drops the head. Kebabes doesn't clinch up. Referee Onari breaks them.
I like those two question mark kicks he threw, and then he went to the body. Oh, no. Ngalani's wobble.
Ngalani momentarily turned his back. Referee, though, didn't see it as a chance to put a count on him. Kebabes comes forward. Here's the left hand from Kebabes. There's the uppercut. Goes to the body. Now toe-to-toe. They juke it out. Kebabes wins the battle. Backs him up with the right hand. Got to get out of the corner here. Ngalani takes a knee. He's lining up the right hand. There it is. And another uppercut. The chin through the top of the head. Ngalani may go down. Ngalani may go down. He's right for the picking. Ngalani on rubber legs. And he's still here. How is he still standing? The man from Hong Kong.
How is he still on his feet? He just got hit with about 13 clean shots. And he's still throwing.
Tremendous heart and intestinal fortitude from Ngalani. Takes another big right hand, and down he goes. Now it's a count on Ngalani. Three knockdowns in one round, and the contest is over. That is knockdown number one in this round on Ngalani, and that is all. The good referee Onari says no more punishment, and it's a TKO victory for Tariq Kebabes.
Wow.
Mitch, that was an absolute war.
Man, those shots, I could feel them in my bones sitting here in the commentary booth. Tariq Kebabes unloaded a fury, but Ngalani stood there like the champ that he is and took it. Took the best that Kebabes had to offer, but ultimately crumbled under the pressure.
Could it be a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night? Take a look at the power here, the volume and power. There was the right hand to the jaw. That's what did the damage. And then he finished off Alain Ngalani. Kebabes, one Super Series debut, will take the win back to the Netherlands and Morocco. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 49 seconds in the third and final round, here is your winner by way of knockout, Tariq Kebabes!
A fantastic victory for Tariq Kebabes of Morocco.
This fight is brought to you by AdReach, meaningful advertising. And these punches should be extremely meaningful. First of all, though, a kick from Alain in the black trunks, Hassan in the pale blue. And if there is a violent takedown in this one, the whole stadium could rock. Oh, my word! A spinning kick that knocked Hassan straight down, and in comes the referee. Kenichi Serizawa didn't want to see any more of that, and I do not blame him.
And then Alain just grazed him right on the temple with that toe.
Seemed to get him around the temple, didn't it? Perhaps
let's
just
take a look
on
at
the
this
top
from
of the
other
nose.
Side.
So rare that these are executed well enough, but yeah, high on the head, that one.
Perfect foot to the temple, and there's a few buttons, and that just put Hassan enough on.
Go!
Brandon Vera immediately starts with some of those brutal leg kicks that he's known for.
And lands to the head.
Paul Cheng trying to answer. Paul Cheng's got to make this fight dirty. He cannot stand there in front of Brandon Vera and let him do what he does best.
Left hook did significant damage. That kick landed flush on the jaw. The follow-up barely needed. We have a heavyweight champion.
Our third man in the circle, referee Elias Dalapsis. 4 ounce gloves on these two behemoths. And the right hand early from Andre the Giant.
Right after the hand touch, he wasted no time rushing Braddock.
Now we got to see Braddock understand what's going on. Now he's gonna try to get nice and patient. Now he starts to counter punch. Watch the left hand, watch the hook to overhand right.
Munhir knows he can't allow Silva to establish his rhythm. He can't allow the big Brazilian to sit the metronome. Trying to give Silva a taste of the right hand early with those 4 ounce gloves. Look by the giant and overhand right. Silva knees on the inside. The giant goes to the body, barrels him against the fence. Ties up Silva and referee Deluxus breaks them. What a crackerjack start to this one.
Munhir's got to be careful. He kind of opens up a little bit when he throws those punches. Braddock might be able to catch him coming in.
High knee there from Anderson Silva. Munhir's got to be careful not to drop the head. Already he's cut from the knee of Anderson Silva. Silva goes to the liver. Overhand right from Silva. Uppercut there from Munhir. Wild look out. Overhand right there from Anderson Silva. Uppercut from the Giants, Andre Munhir. Two huge men in 4 ounce gloves. It's the overhand right on the temple. It hits the button and turns the lights out on the Giant.
Yeah, look, he was just leaving himself a little too open, overextended. He throws that big left hook, gets whiffed.
Ready, go!
And the size of Sakina's head, it's got its own gravitational pull. Charges after Ngalani early. Looking for a takedown, trying to put hands. Oh, Ngalani catches him! It's goodnight, Irene! My word! It's over in a matter of seconds!
Look at this, beautifully timed, measured with the left hand, delivered with the right!
Mitchell was a combination of timing, precision, and Sakina's own forward coming momentum that dropped himself into that right hand. Talk. The time for talk is over. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. That's Mauro Cerilli of Italy. Brandon Vera, defending champion of the Philippines. Vera at 113 kilos, Cerilli at 111 kilos. More beef than a cattle ranch in the cage at the moment. High kick early from Vera. There will be Vera's speed and precision against the raw power of the Italian hammer. And look out for the overhand right on Mauro Cerilli. Vera chopped downstairs. Cerilli wants to bridge the gap, get on the inside, and go for the champion's jaw.
Cerilli's trying to close that distance, having a hard time dealing with the range of Vera. But he's got to get on the inside. He can't stay at the end of these kicks.
Vera has the height. He's got the reach. Wants to keep the Italian at bay. Switches to southpaw here. Look out for the high kick off the left leg here from Vera. It's a lead hook. Oh, swinging.
Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.